What is going on? Today is a new day. You know what that means, new vlog. So let's do this. Okay, so first thing I always do in the morning is come to the office, schedule with some clients for meetups, go and look at some houses. And that's normally my favorite part, is going look at houses. Today's schedule, got a meeting with a client after our team training, and then I got a meeting with a team leader of mine to discuss some future plannings for ChiaTalks. And I had mentioned about this a few days ago in one of my vlogs. So if you guys haven't watched that vlog, make sure you do so. I'll put a link up. But yeah, gotta get to work. So talk to you guys soon. Okay, now gotta get out of here so that way I don't be late for my team training. Today's going to be a productive day. Yes, it will. Productive day, productive day. Today was a pretty chaotic day. Like, we had a team training. It was great. The team training was awesome. You know, as a realtor, I soon realized that part of our job sometimes, there's certain parts of our job that we hate. Makes us stressful, keeps us up at night, and we don't really like to talk about these things. I was sitting down with a buddy of mine today, and you know, we were just talking about how like we learn from our mistakes, but if it wasn't for that mistake, we wouldn't be able to prepare for the next mistake and how to deal with it and so forth. Sometimes, especially earlier on in my career, I would like give away my commission to a lot of the clients just because I would always want to take care of them. I would never want them to feel like it was my fault. And I soon realized that that was my mistake for giving my commission away, because I have worked hard for that commission. You know, it's not like a normal paycheck to where I would get paid consistently every 2 weeks like a 9-to-5 job. It was walking with these people for like a good couple months, and then once the home officially closes, which takes about 30 to 45 days, depending if there's any hiccups or not on the transaction, then I would get paid. Now that I think about it, I would just give this commission check away if something was to happen. For example, this client of mine would move in and experience all these issues, whether it's a leak or whatever. They would call me, of course, because I was their agent. They would call me and tell me, oh my gosh, like, this house is crazy. I don't know why I bought this house. Now this is going on. But you gotta understand, when you buy a resale home, it's not a brand new home. So because it's not a brand new home, things are gonna happen and you're gonna have to maintain it. During the time of the transaction, when we were doing our due diligence, and I spoke about this a lot, during our inspection contingency periods, you know, we hired a company, a great company, to come out and do the due diligence. And they found nothing wrong with the home at the time. You know, sometimes there's incidents that happens, there's coincidence that occur, and something happened. During the process of buying that home, if there's nothing that shows or proves that it's nothing's wrong with it to where the sellers could address it, then you really can't do anything about it. And yeah, you know, sometimes home will just break just by sitting. Like, I've seen homes to where they would just sit, like a brand new home. They would just sit, and in 6 months in, there'd be cracks all over the stuccos or drywall. Like, there'd be cracks everywhere. And it's not anything wrong with the home. It's because you gotta understand that when a home is built, it is built on plain field land, sand. And what happens is when it stays on that land for a long period of time, it settles. So because it settles, it's gonna be shifts in the home. And when it shifts, these stuccos that are meant not to move will crack. And all you gotta do is just go back and fill it in and repaint it and retexture it. But that's just how it is when it comes to owning a home. And I made a video about this not too long ago about how I think some people shouldn't own a home. Because if you're not ready for responsibilities, if you're not ready for maintenance, you shouldn't probably own a home. Because even the brand newest, the newest homes break down over time. And you just have to understand that. So earlier on in my career, like, I didn't know that. So I would always go with the easiest way out, which is give my commission check to go and pay for everything. And that was wrong because I was being selfish, not just to myself, but to my family, because like, this is my livelihood and I can't just always expect people to run me over. And if I did my job, the fact that I'm even answering your call and still helping you, because that's just the person that I am, should already show and prove to you that I'm a good person and that I have bills and I have a life also. And I have a family to feed, a roof to put over our heads. That I'm just in the same boat as you. I have responsibilities as well. Sometimes it's not always the realtor's fault. And I know that there are a lot of realtors out there that are greedy, and that the moment they sell your home and they're gone, they leave you in the dust and they're nowhere to be found. But I'm here to tell you, I am not that type of realtor. The moment I've connected with you, the moment that I've built a relationship with you, the moment that I sell a house to you, you have become family. No matter what you think of me, you have become a friend, you have become family. Because I truly believe that relationship is the key to a long, healthy business. And I'm in it for the long haul. So, can't get rid of me that easy. And I know that this video is a little bit different because I'm sharing. It may seem negative, but really, I think a lot of you guys can learn from my mistakes and some of the stories that I'm sharing. Whether you're in the process of buying a home right now or helping somebody sell a home, you know, you gotta know the expectation of your job and the other person. And you also gotta be realistic with everyone around you. Everyone that is involved in the transaction, you gotta be realistic with it. And sometimes, remember, when you're pointing fingers at somebody, there's always three fingers pointing right back at you. So remember that. And I'm gonna close this video on that. Hopefully you guys enjoy this. Remember, if you haven't subscribed, do so by hitting that red button down below and hit that notification bell. So that way you guys don't miss any videos coming in the future, because I'm going to be uploading every day. So I'll catch you guys tomorrow. Peace out now.